What's up, everybody? So this week I get into why I haven't posted in 3 weeks, and I'll talk about creative block, burnout, and how you get through it. Let's get into it. So creative block can be defined as a personal inability to tap into one's creativity. So according to goodtherapy.org, they break this down in a little bit more detail, where they go into some of the reasons why creative block even happens. You could have gone through a recent breakup, or you could just be dealing with creative exhaustion, which in my case, most likely with the 9 to 5 and trying to keep up with the video posting every week, you could possibly and very likely in today's society be seeking external validation and the old but good one, seeking perfection. Or you could have downright lost the motivation and purpose for the work that you do. You're a creative person and this is the way you live, this is a lifestyle for you, or you're making a salary from it and you're hitting a roadblock. It can be detrimental to your creative juices, your mojo, whatever you want to call it. So how does a creative person such as myself get out of a creative block or a rut, if you will? Well, I'm glad you ask. In this video, I'll be giving you guys some tips and tricks on how I have been personally dealing with creative block these past 3 weeks, and how I'm not completely out of it, but I'm slowly crawling my way out of the creative block. So tip number one is to quit comparing yourself to other people. I'll admit that part of the reason why I haven't started this channel long time ago was because I was comparing myself to others. And that was a big no-no, obviously, from the fact that I just started this channel in September. It is hilarious the extremes that the minds will get to once you start going down that negative path. Oh, I don't live in New York City anymore, so my videos won't be that entertaining. That one had me for a while. Oh, I don't have an interesting day to day. Oh, he is way more articulate than I am. And one of my favorite ones, they own a helicopter. I could never compete with that. So stop comparing yourself to others. Number two, depressurize yourself, right? I gotta do this. I gotta depressurize myself. Now, this may look different for you as it does for me, but here's some of the things that I do. I try to get a good night's sleep, but with the 6-month-old, I really can't get that sleep. And the other one is working out. And I tell you that I recently discovered coffee. Till this point, I really wasn't a fan of coffee, but since my 6-month-old has been born, I have been drinking the thing. I can see why the world is addicted to coffee. I haven't been getting much sleep. The other thing is you can treat yourself. Treat yourself to your favorite meal or have some retail therapy. Some people suggest meditation, and maybe meditation, that word is kind of loaded and heavy, and you feel like you need to be levitating somewhere on the floor. It could just be some quiet time.
Good one.
Moving on.
Psych yourself up. They say that if you fake a smile, your brain won't even tell the difference. So smile. And on top of smiling, listen to that undeniable track that always makes you move. And number four, action. I can't stress this enough. Action will never fail you. Basically, if you're going through a creative rut, a creative block, a burnout, take some breaks, recharge, but then jump right back into action. With good reason, Nike's logo and their entire shtick is just do it. It's action, basically. It's a call to action. Number five. Stop looking for motivation. This is something that myself as a creative was tough for me to wrap my head around. But once I read Mark Manson's The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F***, I realized that motivation was a byproduct of action, not the other way around. As a matter of fact, Mark reasons in his book that if you start with action, motivation and inspiration are soon to follow, which will lead you to more action. And it just becomes this a self-fulfilling, productive prophecy that you definitely want to get into. Action is the biggest antidepressant ever, because when I read this simple thing, it became my mantra. And at that point, so in closing, I hope that you guys got a little bit of insight into what I've been going through and part of the reason why I haven't been filming and how I'm slowly kind of getting myself out of it. So I hope that with these five tips, you guys, those creative folks that are watching this, can, you know, recharge and come back and basically make the world a better place by providing us with your creativity and your art. Thank you all for watching, and subscribe if you haven't already. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Hit that bell for notifications. I will see you sometime this week, because I gotta make up for the past 3 weeks that I didn't, you know. Till then, guys, keep shooting, y'all. Second go round, take one. Marker, what's the undeniable track that makes me dance? I'm rambling. See the other side. Yeah.